إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. الحمد لله. We praise Allah and we seek His assistance and we seek His forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evil within ourselves and from our bad deeds. Whoever Allah guides, there is none that can lead him astray, and whoever is that astray, then there is no guide for him. I bear witness that no God has the right to be worshipped other than Allah. He is alone and has no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and his messenger. O you who believe, fear Allah as you ought to be feared, and don't die except as Muslims. O humanity, fear your Lord who has created you from a single soul and created from it its mate, and scattered from them too many men and women. And fear Allah for we demand your mutual rights, and don't cut off relations with the wounds that bore you. Indeed, Allah is a raqib over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and say that which is correct, in order that He may accept from you your deeds and forgive you of your sins. And whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger achieves the greatest achievement. Amma ba'du. Certainly the most truthful speech is the book of Allah, and the finest guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the most evil of affairs are newly invented matters in this deen, and every newly invented matter in this deen is a bid'ah, and every bid'ah is a string, and every string is in the fire. We continue with the recitation and the translation and the tafsir of Surah Yusuf and the statement of Allah Ta'ala, وَدَخَلَ مَعَهُ السِّجْنَ فَتَيَانِ قَالَ أَحَدُهُمَا إِنِّي أَرَانِي أَعْصِرُ خَمْرًا وقال الآخر إني أراني أحمل فوق رأسي خبزا تأكل الطير منه نبئنا بتأويله إنا نراك من المحسنين. قال لا يأتيكما طعام ترزقانه إلا نبأتكما بتأويله قبل أن يأتيكما، ذلكما مما علمني ربي، إني تركت ملة قوم لا يؤمنون بالله وهم بالآخرة هم كافرون، واتبعت ملة آبائي إبراهيم وإسحاق ويعقوب، ما كان لنا أن نشرك بالله من شيء، ذلك من فضل الله علينا وعلى الناس ولكن أكثر الناس لا يشكرون. يا صاحبي السجن أأرباب متفرقون خير أم الله الواحد القهار؟ ما تعبدون من دونه إلا أسماء سميتموها أنتم وآباؤكم ما أنزل الله بها من سلطان، إن الحكم إلا لله، أمر ألا تعبدوا إلا إياه، ذلك الدين القيم ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون. ذلك الدين القيم ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون. يا صاحبي السجن أما أحدكما فيسقي ربه خمرا وأما الآخر فيصلب فتأكل الطير من رأسه. قضي الأمر الذي فيه تستفتيان. وقال للذي ظن أنه ناج منهما اذكرني عند ربك فأنساه الشيطان ذكر ربه فلبث في السجن بضع سنين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in these ayat, and two young men entered the prison with him, with Yusuf alayhi salam. One of them said, indeed I see that I am pressing wine. Meaning one of the two that entered the prison with Yusuf, he said, indeed I see myself in a dream that I am pressing wine. And the other said, indeed I see myself carrying some bread on top of my head and the birds are eating from it. Inform us of its interpretation. O Yusuf, inform us of the interpretation of these two dreams. Indeed, we see you to be from amongst the doers of good. He said, Yusuf alayhi salam, he said, no food that you will be provided with will come to you until I inform you two of the interpretation of your dreams before the food comes to you. This is from what my Lord has taught me. Meaning the interpretation of dreams is from what my Lord has taught me. Indeed, I left the religion of a people who disbelieve in Allah, and in the hereafter they are disbelievers. And I followed the religion of my forefathers, Ibrahim and Ishaq and Ya'qub. It is not for us to commit shirk in Allah. It is not for us to worship other than Allah along with Allah. It is not for us to ascribe partners in worship with Allah, or any partners in worship with Allah. That is from Allah's favor upon us and upon humanity, but most of the people are ungrateful. That is Allah's favor upon us, meaning that He made us prophets, and it's a favor upon humanity that He sent those prophets to them. But most of humanity is ungrateful or not thankful. Oh, my two companions in prison, are many separate gods better, or al-wahidu al-qahhar? Are there many separate gods who do not benefit or who do not harm? Are they better for you to worship, or Allah the one, the dominant, the one who everything must submit to? You only worship besides Him names that you and your father have made, of which Allah has given you no authority. You only worship besides Him, besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, names, idols that you and your fathers have made up to be worshipped besides Allah, but Allah has given no one the permission to make these idols or to worship them besides Allah. The only verdict is with Allah, and He has commanded that none be worshipped except Him. This is the true upright deen, but most of the people do not know. O my two companions in prison, as far as one of you is concerned, then he will, and this is the interpretation of the dream, indeed he will pour the wine for his master, meaning for the king. And as far as the other, then he will be crucified, and the birds will be eating from his head. This is the matter that has been decided for you that you have questioned about. And then he said to the one who he knew was going to be set free, meaning the one who would give drink to his master, meaning to be the server or the pourer for the king. So he, Yusuf alayhi salam, he said to the one who he knew that was going to be saved, remember me with your Lord. Remember me with your master, the king. So Allah made him forget. So the shaytan made him forget the remembrance of his Lord, and he remained in the prison for some years. Here the ulama, they give two explanations to this last statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Yusuf alayhi salam, when he knew
the one who was going to be saved of the two, because one was going to be killed by being crucified and the birds will eat from his head. The other one that was going to pour drink, the drink for the king, and he was going to be saved from being executed. Then Yusuf asked him to mention Yusuf's case with the king, meaning to plead my case to the king on my behalf. When you go to the king to pour a drink for him, then let him know that I have been wrongly imprisoned, that maybe he might let me go. As I have interpreted this dream for you, then help me out. But the shaytan made him forget the remembrance of his Lord. Some of the ulama, they say what is meant by here, so the shaytan made him forget the remembrance of his Lord, meaning the shaytan made Yusuf alayhi salam forget to remember Allah and to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and not to ask the king, but to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he forgot the remembrance of his Lord, and because of it, he remained in the prison for a number of years. Bilba'a sineen, meaning 3 to 9 years. And some of the ulama say 7 years, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Others from amongst the ulama, they say what is meant by it, So the shaytan made him forget the remembrance of his Lord. His Lord referring to the master, to the king. So the shaytan made the one who poured the drink for the king, made him forget Yusuf's case when he was with the king. So because he did not present Yusuf's case to the king, then Yusuf was made to stay in prison for a certain number of years. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. And these ayah, we see that there are many benefits. From amongst the benefits is the importance of giving da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and being focused in giving our da'wah, and not letting the circumstances and the situations, or the ones that we are calling to the truth of al-Islam, to divert us from calling them to Islam because of any particular situation. As we saw here in the case with Yusuf alayhi salam and his two companions that were with him in the prison, they wanted the interpretation of the dream. But before Yusuf alayhi salam interpreted the dream, he gave them something that was more beneficial to them than answering their questions or interpreting the dreams. He called them to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And this is for us as Muslims also. Whatever we find ourselves in of circumstances and situations, whatever questions we feel that we're being bombarded with, let's not be focused or distracted from the da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Call to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then handle whatever has to be handled afterwards. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to be Muslims who are not distracted or diverted, but Muslims who are focused on giving da'wah to Allah.
بسم الله الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله.
We see in these ayat and in other ayat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's book the call or the commandment and the encouragement for the believers to give da'wah to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in other ayat,
وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, and let there arise from amongst you a group that is calling to the good, that is calling to the deen of al-Islam and the sunnah of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are enjoining what is right, meaning they are calling people to obedience to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they are forbidding what is wrong. They are forbidding that which Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbids, or that which is in opposition to the Quran and the Sunnah. Those from amongst us, from amongst the Muslims, the party who is calling to al-Islam, those, they are the successful. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in other ayat,
ادع إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة وجادلهم بالتي هي أحسن إن ربك يعلم من إن ربك هو أعلم بمن ضل عن سبيله وهو أعلم بالمهتدين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, call to the path of your Lord, meaning give da'wah to the deen of your Lord, to the deen of al-Islam. Call to the path of your Lord with hikmah, with wisdom, with the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and beautiful exhortation. Beautiful exhortation, call them to the reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their righteous deeds and good belief. Beautiful exhortation, warn them from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their disbelief and their bad deeds, and argue and debate with them in the finest manner, meaning with gentleness and compassion and mercy and softness. Indeed, your Lord knows best who is guided, and He knows best who has gone astray from His path. Meaning it's only upon you to deliver the message, and it's on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do the guiding. It's only on you to deliver the message. Don't worry about whether someone will believe in what you say or he will not accept your da'wah. What is important is to give the da'wah. The success is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we ask Him to make us successful in our giving of the da'wah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in other ayat, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِّمَّنْ دَعَا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. And who is more finer in speech than the one who calls to Allah, than the one who gives da'wah to the deen of al-Islam and works righteous deeds and says, indeed I am from amongst the Muslims. No one is more finer in speech than the one who calls to the deen of Allah and his deeds are righteous, and he says he's from amongst the Muslims. Don't be afraid in whatever circumstances that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests you in, but be from amongst the finest, those who say that we are Muslims, who have beautiful character and righteous deeds, those who call to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah make us from amongst them. We also see in the end of Surah Yusuf, and inshallah ta'ala we will get to that ayah and take a more deeper look at it inshallah. Allah calls us in the same surah and other ayat to give the da'wah to His deen. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُو إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرًا أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in this ayah, say, this is my path. I am calling to Allah with proof and evidences and knowledge, me and those who are with me. And subhanallah, I am not from amongst the mushrikeen. I am not from amongst those who worship other than Allah along with Allah. Or I'm not from amongst those who ascribe partners in worship with Allah. I'm not from amongst idolaters. I'm from amongst those who call to the path of Allah with basira, with knowledge and proof and evidences. These are some ayah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's book, commanding and calling the believers to give da'wah to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take advantage of whatever opportunity you have to give da'wah to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we saw was the case of Yusuf alayhi salam. He was in a difficult situation, but on top of his situation being difficult, by being accused unjustly and imprisoned because of it, and being asked many questions, he still called to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on top of anything. With his beautiful character, he called to the deen of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to beautify our character and call to his deen. The last prophet and messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to send his companions out to give the da'wah to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we see in the narration of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu ma qal, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لمعاذ بن جبل حين بعثه إلى اليمن إنك ستأتي قوما أهل كتاب فإذا جئتهم فدعهم فإذا جئتهم فادعهم إلى أن يشهدوا أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله. وفي رواية فادعهم إلى عبادة الله، وفي رواية فادعهم إلى أن يوحدوا الله. فإذا هم أطاعوك لذلك فأخبرهم أن الله قد افترض عليهم 5 صلوات في كل يوم وليلة، فإنهم أطاعوا لك بذلك فأخبرهم أن الله قد فرض عليهم صدقة تؤخذ من أغنيائهم فترد على فقرائهم، فإنهم أطاعوا لك بذلك فإياك وكرائم أموالهم، واتق دعوة المظلوم فليس بينه وبين الله حجاب. متفق عليه. عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما، he said that the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said to Mu'adh ibn Jabal when he sent him to Yemen. The messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he sent Mu'adh ibn Jabal to Yemen after the Muslims had conquered that land. And the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, indeed you will come to a people of Ahlul Kitab. You will come across the Jews and the Christians. So call them to bear witness to La ilaha illallah and Muhammad is Rasulullah. So call them to bear witness that no God has the right to be worshipped but Allah, and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Or as it says in the other narration, call them to the worship of Allah, the ibadatullah. Or as it says in the other narration, call them to make Allah one. And all of these narrations are the same. Call them to the deen of al-Islam, to the deen of tawheed, to the deen of the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, without ascribing any partners in worship with Allah. If they obey you in that. Or as it says in one of the narrations, فَإِذَا عَرَفُ اللَّهُ. So when they know Allah, when they know who their Lord is, and that He is the only one who has the right to be worshipped, if they follow you in that, then teach them that Allah has made 5 salat compulsory upon them every day. And if they obey you in that, then teach them that Allah has made sadaqah an obligation upon the wealthy to be given to the poor. And if they obey you in that, then be aware of taking from them their wealth unjustly, their good wealth from them unjustly. And be aware of the dua of the oppressed, because there is no barrier between the dua of the oppressed and their Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. Here the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches his companions to give da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the Jews and Christians in particular. And this is our case right here in this country. And this is guidance from Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how to give da'wah to his deen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he told Mu'adh and Abu Musa al-Ashari radiyallahu anhuma. And another hadith also collected by Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yassira wa la tu'assira, wa bashira wa la tunaffira, wa tatawa'a wa la takhtalifa. Or kama qala alayhi salatu wa salam. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Abu Musa and Mu'adh radiyallahu anhuma, when they were outgoing giving da'wah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to them, be easy and don't be difficult. Be inviting and don't chase away. Agree and don't disagree. This is guidance from the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam in giving da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's deen. And the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, and the other hadith collected by Al-Bukhari, also showing the importance of giving da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's deen and not worrying about our circumstances or the situation, but worrying about the magnificent reward with giving da'wah to Allah. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to Ali radiallahu anhu, فَوَاللَّهِ لِأَنْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكَ رَجُلًا خير لك من أن يكون خير لك من أن يكون لك حرم النعم. أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, I swear by Allah that to guide one man on your hands, to have Allah allow you to guide one man, is better for you than the finest camel or the finest piece of property. And this is collected authentically by Al-Bukhari rahimahullah and others, where the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he shows us the importance of giving da'wah to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even if only one person is guided, even if no people are guided, we are to give the da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's deen. As Allah ta'ala says in other ayat, إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Indeed, you don't guide who you love, but Allah, He guides whoever He wills. Or as Allah says in other ayat, لَيْسَ عَلَيْكَ هُدَاهُمْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. It is not on you to actually guide them, but Allah guides whoever He wills. It's our responsibility to give da'wah to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just as we saw Yusuf alayhi salam in difficult situations giving the da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we find ourselves in these difficult times, some of us being accused unjustly, let's not let that bother us or worry us. Let's not be bothered and worried about the many questions that we are bombarded with. Let's worry about giving the da'wah to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then let's handle the questions in light of the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ إِنَّ السَّمْعَ وَالْبَصَرَ وَالْفُؤَادَ كُلُّ أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْئُولًا. And don't say what you have no knowledge of. Indeed, the hearing and the sight and the intellect will all be questioned. We'll be questioned about everything that we say when we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why answer questions that you have no knowledge of? Why comment on issues that you're ignorant of? Leave it to the people who know to handle the affairs and give da'wah to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as you have been called to give da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's deen. Oh Allah, make us from the guided, those who give guidance, those who call to your deen. Oh Allah, make us from amongst the guided who guide to your deen. Oh Allah, make us from amongst the guided who guide to your deen. Oh Allah, show us the importance of giving da'wah to your deen and bless us with giving da'wah to your deen. Oh Allah, bless us to give da'wah to your deen. Oh Allah, help us to give da'wah to your deen. Oh Allah, help us to be focused in giving da'wah to your deen. Oh Allah, prevent us from being distracted of giving da'wah to your deen. Oh Allah, make it easy for Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, make us from the party who calls to the good, the party who calls to Islam and the sunnah of your Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, make it easy on us and the Muslims in these difficult times. Oh Allah, make it easy on us and the Muslims in these difficult times. Oh Allah, make it easy on us and the Muslims in these difficult times. Oh Allah, protect us. Oh Allah, help us. Oh Allah, save us from being killed at the hands of the enemies. No one can save us except you. Oh Allah, make it easy for us and easy for the Muslims all over the world. Nothing will take place except the way that you decreed. So decree good for us wherever we are, and make us live on this deen of al-Islam and die on this deen of al-Islam. Oh Allah, we ask you for Jannah. Oh Allah, we ask you for Jannah. Oh Allah, we ask you for Jannah. Oh Allah, save us from the fire. Oh Allah, save us from the fire. Oh Allah, the real punishment is the fire, so save us from the fire. Oh Allah, give us the good in this world and the good in the hereafter, and save us from the fire. هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وسبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك, والحمد لله.